Now that we've finished talking about how the organelles work together inside of a cell to help the cell run, now we're going to expand even bigger. So cells build together to build tissues, tissues work together to build organs, organs work together to build organ systems, and organ systems work together to build an organism. So we're going to go all the way up to an entire organism, and we'll use the human body since we're the most familiar with that. But ultimately, every organism needs its cells to work together, or needs its organ systems to work together in order for that organism to run, just like your organelles need to work together to allow your cell to run. So they're independent on, or they're interdependent on each other in order for the organism to function. So the idea of interdependence is when two or more systems in your body work together to help the organism run. There's 11 different organ systems in the human body. We'll be focusing on 8 of them this year. So the first system we'll look at is the skeletal system. So our skeletal system, you're familiar with because of the bones that you normally see that provide shape and support for the body. But another thing that it does is helps to protect our organs underneath, particularly under our rib cage, like our heart and our lungs. But it also produces red blood cells within each bone. So it's interdependent with the circulatory system. It stores calcium, and then the joints allow us to also move our body so that we're not just one straight up and down organism. The main organs that are in our skeletal system are our bones, which are the harder calcified structure, but also our cartilage, which would be things like our nose and our ears. They're a little more flexible, but do provide some structure. And then ligaments, which are an even softer tissue that helps connect our bones together at the joints. Another system we'll look at is our muscular system. So our muscular system is what allows us to move and lift things. You're familiar with the muscles that are red in this picture, but our muscles do more than just allow us to move. They also protect our body and help to keep us upright and keep our balance. They also include helping maintain body temperature. So our main organs involved in the muscular system are our muscles, but also our tendons. Tendons, when you look at this picture, are the whiter, lighter part that help connect those muscles to the bones. The next system we'll look at is the respiratory system. So you're familiar with cellular respiration, which is the process of taking in oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide at the cell level. Your body also does respiration to allow that oxygen and carbon dioxide to get in and out of your body. There's quite a few organs involved in your respiratory system. The nose and mouth are the first two that oxygen comes in contact with, and the last two that carbon dioxide comes in contact with. So as oxygen comes in through your nose and mouth, it comes down through the pharynx and the trachea. The trachea is a harder tube that is surrounded by cartilage to help keep it from collapsing so that air is always able to travel through your airway. And as that tube gets smaller, it branches off into what are called bronchii. And those bronchii go down into your lungs and get smaller and smaller until they reach a small air sac called alveoli. And those alveoli are where the oxygen actually leaves your lungs and goes into your bloodstream. And in turn, your bloodstream gives carbon dioxide back to your lungs, or the alveoli. And then that carbon dioxide travels back up your bronchii, back up your trachea, out the pharynx, and eventually out your nose and mouth. The diaphragm is one last organ that's involved with your breathing, and it's a muscular layer that's found just below your lungs that helps to keep your breathing pattern regulated. The next system we'll look at is our digestive system. Our digestive system is in charge of breaking down food, both mechanically and chemically. So mechanically being through movement, just changing the way it looks, mashing it up, and chemically being that it's actually changing the way the molecules are put together. So when you think about the chemical reaction that we talked about with photosynthesis and respiration, Now your stomach is doing that same thing, breaking down the molecules that might be in your cheeseburger into usable molecules such as glucose that your body needs. Your digestive system also absorbs those nutrients that have been broken down and then eliminates the waste that you don't need. There's a lot of organs involved in this system. So the first organ that you're familiar with is your mouth. And your food enters through your mouth, travels down your esophagus, which is a muscular tube that actually squeezes the food down into your stomach. Once it reaches your stomach squeezes and squishes and mixes it with digestive juices until it's broken down into something that's no longer your lunch. So if you ate a cheeseburger, by the time it's done in your stomach, you no longer have cheeseburger. You have chemicals. And that chemical passes down into your small intestine, where all the different nutrients that have been broken down by your stomach acid and bile are absorbed into your bloodstream. And this is a very long tube that takes a long time for your food to travel through, in and out, to absorb all of those nutrients that you need. By the time it gets to the end of the tube, it's entering your large intestine. And your large intestine is in charge of absorbing any last nutrients that might still be left, but more importantly, it's going to absorb out the water that's with the waste products that aren't needed from your food. And as it travels, it takes out as much water as it can and then stores the waste product in the rectum, and eventually it's then passed out of your body. A few other organs you're less familiar with are your liver, your gallbladder, and your pancreas. These are organs that the food doesn't actually travel through, but they create digestive juices and hormones that allow your body to actually do the digesting. So your liver is going to produce something called bile that then is stored in your gallbladder, and that's one of the things that's released into your stomach to help the digestion take place. Another thing that's going to help is your pancreas, and your pancreas produces hormones, which are another chemical that your body uses. And one example would be insulin. Insulin is going to be a hormone that helps to regulate how much blood sugar is in your body. The next system is our urinary system. So our urinary system eliminates the liquid waste from our body, and then it also regulates how much fluid we actually have in our body in each individual cell. So the main organs that we have here are our kidneys. There's two kidneys that filter the waste and toxins out of your blood. The ureter, which allows the waste to travel down into your bladder where it's stored, and then the urethra, where it eventually leaves your body. Another system is our integumentary system. This system is often thought of as our skin, but there's actually a lot that goes into this one. So your integumentary system protects your body. It helps you feel what's around you, sense heat and pain. It also helps to maintain your body temperature, produces vitamin D, which is critical for your body to be able to function. And then it also helps to eliminate waste through your sweat. So the main organ here is your skin, and your skin has three layers: your epidermis, your dermis, and a fatty layer that's underneath. But within your skin is a lot of other things. You have your hair follicles. There's also sweat glands and oil glands. There's blood vessels and nerve endings, and all of those different pieces help for your body to do regulation, to release sweat and maintain body temperature, to sense the world around you. So your integumentary system, although we often think of it as our skin, has a lot more going on. Another system is our circulatory system. Our circulatory system is a path or routes for our blood to flow through our body and then transport nutrients and transport waste out of our cells, nutrients to our cells, and waste out of our cells. The main organs here are our heart, our arteries, and our veins. So our heart is at the center of our body, and that heart pumps blood out into the arteries, which are diagrammed in red here. And the arteries have oxygen-rich blood that sends oxygen out to every cell in your body. And as that oxygen gets used up, your cells do cellular respiration and pass carbon dioxide back into your veins. And then your veins carry that blood back to your heart, and then your heart pumps it out to your lungs so that it can get rid of that carbon dioxide. When it's getting rid of the carbon dioxide in your lungs, then your lungs give oxygen back to your blood, and then it's carried back to your heart and again back out to your body. The last system we'll talk about is our nervous system. And our nervous system is responsible for gathering information and processing what's going on in the world around us. The main organs here are our brain, our spinal cord, and our peripheral nerves. So our brain is in our head. It's our main organ that does reasoning and thought, controls our actions and our speech, and controls all of our main body organs. Every message that our body receives is processed in our brain, and it travels to and from our brain through a cord called our spinal cord, which is a bundle of nerves that runs down our spine or vertebrae in our back. The vertebrae are one organ or bone that protects the spinal cord. From there, there's peripheral nerves that branch out into the rest of our body that gather information and send information back out, such as when you're feeling a hot stove, a message is sent up through your nerves to your spinal cord, back to your brain, and then eventually a message is sent back down to your muscles saying, hey, you need to get your hand off that stove because it's really hot. And that's just a few of the systems that work together in our body or are interdependent within our body that help us function as an organism.